This Torah class is brought to you by TorahAnytime.com.
When Korach starts opposing Moshe Rabbeinu, we found that Moshe Rabbeinu asks that the Adama should open up its mouth and swallow them. Adama is the land. The Pasuk says, "Im b'riah ivra Hashem upatzta ha'adama et piya ubala otam ve'et kol asher lahem ve'ardu chayim she'ola." Later on again he speaks about the Adama. He says, "Ve'ikach alotol et ebeer v'tibaka ha'adama asher tachtehem." It's the Adama. But when the Pasukim speak later on, they don't speak about Adama, they speak about the Eretz. It says in the Pasuk, "Vatiftach ha'aretz et piya, vatechas aleim ha'aretz, v'chol Yisrael nasu lekolam, ki amru tiv leenu ha'aretz." So what is it? Adama, Aretz, is it the same thing? It's land, just in different names. What is it exactly? Also, we found that Korach himself is still alive on the ground. This is how the Torah says, "Chaim she'ola." And the Midrash says that constantly they say, in underground, Moshe emet, v'torato emet, v'em badaim, they're alive underground forever and ever. How could anybody live underground? When the ground is over you, you die instantly. There's no oxygen, there's no food, there's no place to live. How do they live over there? We found in Bnei Korach, the children of Korach, it says in one place, Bnei Korach lo metu, and another place, that everybody died. V'tivla et kol ha'adam asher leKorach, even his children. So Rashi says, to explain that the children of Korach indeed made Teshuvah in the last minute, and because of that, Nivtzar lehem makom gavoah begeinom. They're not so low underground, but rather on a higher place. Who cares if they're in a low place, in a high place, in the end of the day, they're underground. What's the difference? Well, to explain that, we need to go and see what the Zohar says. The Zohar in a few places, and actually in the beginning of the Zohar, explains in Midrash Ne'elam that there are seven different worlds under our world. We have our world and six other worlds under our world, and each one has a different name. As the Zohar explains in Midrash Ne'elam, the name of those worlds, and it names it Eretz, Adama, Arka, Gei, Neshiah, Tzia, Tevel. Rav Yehuda says that just like the Kadosh Baruch Hu created Shiva Rekiim, seven different worlds on top of our world, he created also seven worlds underground, which means our world and six under our world. Just like an onion that has layers, there are different worlds under our worlds. Nayahu ben Yehoyada explains that the length from one world to another is as long as it takes you to walk 500 years. 500 years distance of walking, that is what it takes to get to the next world under us. And each and every world is the same length from the other world. To explain that, says the Zohar Chadash, interesting, he says, the Sidura de Alma Sheva Ratzot Inun Da Le'ela Min Da. Each world is on top of the other. What's the purpose of this world, and who's there, and what's there? Says the Zohar the following: Kanafak Adam migenta de Eden v'itarech mitaman. When Adam Rishon was kicked out from Gan Eden, itram elahu deikre aretz. He went to the lower world, all the way underground, and that is called Eretz. Deihu atar chashich de letaman ira klum. It's a dark place without any light. Very scary place. Velo meshamesh klum. There's nothing that lights over there. Complete darkness. Kevan she'adam al taman dachil tchilu tuva. Which means Adam Rishon, when he got there, he got very scared. He was very afraid. It also has over there cherev hamithapechet. Very, very scary things around there. So right away he made teshuvah. Kevan denafik shabbat. After he made Teshuvah, Motzei Shabbat, HaKadosh Baruch Hu picked him up to the next world after that, and that is called Adama. In Adama, says the Zohar, it's a place with light. Vayishalchehu Hashem Elokim migan Eden la'avod et Adama. He took him out to a land called Adama. Behai itnoru denair, the dukna de kochvaya umazale, which means over there, there are some lights of stars and some constellation. This is for Adam Rishon. Taman tiurim, dane nasha, ilain guvrin, den fakume Adam kadma, inu nativin, tadir, velet bar chedva. Says the Zohar, it's a place that people that are the descendants of Adam Rishon, which means the Zohar explains that Adam Rishon had children that lived there, except the children that he had, where we see with Cain and Hevel, he also had a lot of children in those 130 years that he was there in Adama. And all those are his descendants that live in there. And those people that live in the land called Adama are constantly always sad and never happy. That's what the Zohar says. Inun atzivin tadir, they're constantly sad, velet bao chedva. Vilen meshateti venafki la'almada. They sometimes come out of there and go out of that world and they come back there. That is Adam Rishon. We have a story with Cain. Kevan shechata Cain achit lekutcha birichu la'u atar deikri eretz. When Cain sinned, Kadosh Baruch Hu took him also to the place called Eretz. Dichtiv and gerashta oti ayom me'al pnei adama. Ma'u atar deikri adama. Adam Rishon took Cain from the place that he was by Adama and took him down to Eretz. And it says over there, "Va'iti na ve'nad ba'aretz begin the taman itchaya v'itatarech ve'aya kol motzi yargeni." It was a very scary place, the Eretz, as we explained before. It's darkness, there's nothing there. Says the Zohar, there was also la'at ha'cheref ha'mitapechet v'avedachil v'irer b'tshuva. Cain was so scared, he also made teshuva. So what did HaKadosh Baruch Hu do? He picked him up, but not only to Adama, to a land called Arka. That's the third land. You have the lowest land called Eretz, Adama, Arka. HaKadosh Baruch Hu picked him up to Arka. And all the descendants in Arka are his descendants. It says the Zohar, in that land you have very large people and very small people. Two kinds of people over there. Very big giants and very small people. Also, the Zohar explained that they don't have da'at shelema, which means they're not fully capable of understanding things. Adam have ba'adama adolid shet umitaman salik le'ela arba dargin mikain. Went up. The Zohar explains each and every land, and it comes out like this, that the lowest land says, the Zohar is, as we explained right now, the Eretz, which is a dark place without any light, a very scary place. Over there, Adam Rishon was there until he made Teshuvah and HaKadosh Baruch Hu picked him up to Adama. In Adama, there are stars and there are people, but they're always sad, they're never happy. Over there was the descendants of Cain and Hevel, which were born in Adama. Arka is the next one. That already is a place with stars and a sun. And over there were the descendants of Cain after he made Teshuvah. We just explained that they had large people and small people. Above that, there's a land called Gei, which are the descendants of those from Migdal Bavel, those that made the Tower of Bavel. They were punished. And there, says the Zohar, people are very smart. On top of that, the next world is what we call Neshia, from the word, Aramaic word of forgetting, because the people there constantly forget everything. The very minor people, says the Zohar, very tiny and minor people, and their legs are cut. But the Zohar also explained that those people have no nose, rather, in their face. They just have two holes, and that is where they breathe. But they don't have a nose like human beings do. On top of that, there's something called Tzia, which is a land with beautiful people. And the seventh world, which is all the way on top, is our world called Tevel. This is what David HaMelech says. Beterem arim yuladu, before HaKadosh Baruch Hu created mountains and everything else, v'techolel eretz v'tevel. HaKadosh Baruch Hu created eretz, that's the lowest of all, v'tevel, and everything in between. We live in Tevel. There's a story in the Midrash that Tosfot brings in Menachot Lamed Zayin, that Ashmedai, which is the king of the Shedim, came to Shlomo HaMelech and told him, "Do you want me to show you something that you've never seen before? Even as smart as person as Shlomo HaMelech, never seen before?" Shlomo said, "Yeah, of course, show me." Ashmedai put his hand down and took out a man with two heads. Shlomo HaMelech was fascinated by such a thing. He never saw such a thing, a person with two heads. He told him, "There's a world underground that has people with two heads. And this is one of the worlds we're talking about. A world with people that live in there that have two heads." Shlomo HaMelech, when he saw that, he called Benayahu, Ben Yoyada. He told him, "Did you ever see such a thing?" He told him, "Yeah, Achitofel told me there's worlds underground with such people." Wow! Shlomo HaMelech approached the person with two heads. He told him, "You want to go back?" He told him, "Yeah, I have nothing to do here. My family, my house is not here." So he came to Ashmedai and told him, "Okay, take the person back." Ashmedai told him, "No, once I take somebody out, I can't bring him back." So says the Midrash that that man lived amongst people and he had a wife, and that wife that he married, which had only one head, had also children. Those children, some had two heads and some had one head. Eventually, this man with the two heads dies and he leaves a property. The children started fighting over the property. Who inherits it? Comes the child with the two heads and says, "I have to get two parts of the inheritance because I'm a two-person head." The children said, "No, you're one person with two heads." He said, "No, two heads represent two people. I have to get two parts." They came in front of Shlomo HaMelech. Shlomo HaMelech was thinking. He never had such a story before. He told him, "Come back tomorrow morning." At night, he was thinking and praying to HaKadosh Baruch Hu to give him the wisdom to judge correctly. In the morning, he came up with an idea. He told his servant, "Come and cover one of the heads with a towel that he doesn't see what happens, and warm for me some hot water." After he did that, he took the water and he poured it on the head that was covered. And both heads started screaming. He told the head that was covered, "Why are you screaming? What happened?" He told him, it's hot. "Ah, it's hot. It's hot on the other head, not your head. I see you are one person and therefore you deserve only one portion." But from those stories, we see that there are such creatures that live underground. And we sometimes experience stories of different creatures that come to our world. And some say it's fiction, it's not true, it is true. But from here, we see that there are such creatures that live underground under us. And this is openly in the Zohar, in the Mefarshim, it's all over. It's something that is clearly there. And the Mefarshim explain it literally and not as some kind of story or parable or anything spiritual. No, it's literally, it's physical, it's underground. And if that is the case, we can definitely now understand what happened to Korach. Korach was punished. He went underground. Where do you go underground? Moshe Rabbeinu was praying they should go only up to Adama, not to this terrible, terrible place of Eretz, Adama. But since Korach didn't do Teshuvah, he didn't go just to Adama, but even lower than that, to Eretz. But Bnei Korach, which do Teshuvah, but the only Me'arher Teshuvah, it wasn't a complete Teshuvah, they got stuck in Adama without going lower than that. Adama isn't that terrible. And that is what Rashi tells us, Makom gavoa niftzar lahem begeinom. It's a higher place. That is where they live. Could people live in there? Indeed. People live in there. People eat in there. They have children. Everything is open in the Zohar. We learn from here a beautiful, beautiful piece of information of what also happens around our world. Besides what we can see in our eyes, the Zohar explains to us and opens to us new understanding of what happens underground in our own world.
You've just experienced another Torah class brought to you by TorahAnytime.com.